Hello. With this video, we want to give you a little background about the technical design, testing and certification of our lifts. Different regulations and certifications apply at different stages of use. During lifting of the load, the DGUV-17 regulation, formerly known as BGVC1, applies. Therefore, the lift has several extra security measures, such as automatic activated safety pins, as well as dedicated signage on the product. The lifts also have to be certified by an accredited inspector. At this stage of use, the lift is also considered a machine and therefore must comply with the European Machine Directive. A risk analysis and the CE logo on the product are some of the requirements. Once the load is at trim height and the safety pins are secured, the winch is no longer supporting the load and it transitions into a structure. As it is now a structure, the lift needs to be TÜV Baumuster approved. Part of the certification procedure and to meet the latest design standard for lifts, the functional safety test is conducted with the lift positioned on a 5% inclined floor to simulate imperfections of build-ups. It should be well noted that this does not allow a user to erect the lift at this angle. For user friendliness, the lift comes standard with a special flexible steel wire that requires less maintenance, screw jacks with sturdy trapezium tread, which are much more robust for the use on the road than prevailing versions of competitors in the same price range, increased length of screw jacks for the ease of leveling, and lifting fork load and position indicators. We would like to focus now on the use of lifts in outdoor situations. Despite what many manufacturers might tell you, the use of guy wires to stabilize the setup should be treated with great care as it will increase the vertical load in the lift. The amount of the increase depends on the size of the load, the wind speed and the angle of the guy wire. A structural analysis to predict the applying force is required. As an example, we took a common cold post setup made with ML2 lifts. The self-weight of all loads is 300 kg and the total surface area exposed to wind is 3.2 square meters. The following picture shows the additional load guy wires generate under a 45-degree angle at different wind speeds. When the angle becomes steeper, the load increases significantly compared to the previous example. So watch out, because you can easily overload your lift. We hope this video provides you with more insight for the safe use of wind-up lifts. Thank you, and let's lift up our industry together.